Greetings, everyone. As always, Ryan Callahan, Wealth Planner with Northeast Planning Associates, coming to you with another session of Everything Money, the video series where we talk about everything related to money. I learned early on in life, even from the time I got my first paycheck working at the local bakery in my town as a pizza cutter, it's not how much you make that matters, but it's how much you keep. There are two things guaranteed in life. That's death and taxes. And the latter is always up for discussion in terms of its rates and its impact. Full disclosure. As I know it's a very sensitive subject, I am not talking politics today. This has nothing to do with Trump good, Trump bad, Biden good, Biden bad. This is literally information we are getting regarding new upcoming tax legislation. So here's where we are right now, and a lot of this depends on the Senate race in Georgia next month, as there could be a shift in the balance of power in the Senate. There are multiple proposed changes, but I want to focus on the ones that I think will have the biggest impact. The current gift and estate tax exemption is $11.58 million for gift, estate, and generation skip and transfer taxes. That number is for each spouse. So in total, between two spouses, the exemption is $23.16 million. That means you can gift that much money or have that much as your overall estate value and not pay federal estate taxes. For the last few years, the majority of families in this country have not had a federal estate tax problem because most families in this country don't have estates worth more than $23.16 million. The proposal from Biden is to lower that exemption to $3.5 million for estate taxes and down to $1 million for gifts. So between two people, that would be $7 million for the estate and $2 million respectively for the gifts. That really changes things, as there are much more families in this country that have estates worth more than $7 million. But what's even bigger is separating the gift exemption, as there are many families that are gifting more than $2 million to loved ones. You will hear more about ILITs, I-L-I-T strategies, that stands for Irrevocable Life Insurance Trusts, if this tax plan were to come to fruition. We'll have a separate video on ILITs to discuss that planning strategy for estate planning purposes. Another big change would be that appreciated assets no longer get what's called a step up in basis at death. What does this mean? Well, for years, even decades for that matter, a step up in basis was a huge benefit for individuals who were looking to gift securities at death to their loved ones. Let's look at an example here. Let's say you have a dad who's buying a stock at $5 per share, and that stock appreciates to $100 per share. So XYZ stock here, at $5, it goes up to $100 per share. If that father wanted to gift that stock to his daughter while he was alive, he would sell the stock, have to pay the capital gains on the appreciation of that stock, and then gift it to his daughter. Now, from a financial planning standpoint, if this is possible, what always made sense was to gift the stock at death through the estate. Why? Because of the step up in basis. So what would happen in this situation is dad passes away. The value of the stock is $100 at his death. So even though he bought it for five and it appreciated to 100, because of the way that the step up in basis worked is the value at death is 100. The daughter can actually take the stock after death and sell it for no gain. Because of that step up, it was a huge tax advantage for many families looking to transition securities. What's being proposed now is to take that away. Doesn't matter if you're alive or if you're passing to death, the person inheriting the security is inheriting this basis as well. This is a big deal, folks. We're not talking about millions of dollars here. For any person that wants to pass securities to their loved ones that has a significant gain on it, it's going to be impacted by this policy. Now, for income tax purposes, the current highest marginal tax rate is going to increase from 37% to 39.6%. The preferential 20% maximum income tax rate on long-term cap gains and dividends is going to be eliminated for taxpayers with an annual income of over $1 million, bringing their effective tax rate to that 39.6%. Itemized deductions, including charitable deductions, they're going to be capped at a 28% tax bracket. What's also very important to note is that any of these changes enacted during 2021 likely will be retroactive to January 1st of 2021. and such retroactive application of these taxes has been held to be constitutional. So let's go back to this example here real quick. So dad passed away in January of 2021. Daughter inherited the stock. She got the step up in basis. She took this money, paid off her mortgage, paid off her student loans, whatever it is. Well, the tax bill gets passed later in the year. Well, now the government can come back and say, well, hey, any appreciation now that you actually had in that gift, you have to pay capital gains tax on that. So the money's been spent. Nothing was withheld to pay taxes. This can become a very challenging situation. The moral of this whole story is planning in 2021 is going to be more essential than in recent memory. We're dealing with a moving target, and it's not just going to impact the quote unquote rich. Yes, the proposal was that no one making more than $400,000 is going to see a change in their income tax brackets, and that looks to be the case. However, this tax plan, it's going after estates, and this change in step up and basis affects anyone who was going to pass any security, regardless of what their income or their net worth is. So we're here to help. These questions are coming at us daily at what we think's happening. And once again, this is all really dependent on what's happening with the Senate race in Georgia, but we will keep you up to speed as much as we know. You can reach us directly at 833-CALPLAN, that's 833-225-7526, or visit our website, www.callahanplans.com. We look forward to continuing the conversation with you. Take care.